ये जो आप पिछले 30 साल से कंटिन्यूअसली यूनाइटेड नेशंस में मूलनिवासी बहुजनों की समस्याओं को बाहर रिप्रेजेंट कर रहे हैं, ये जानना चाहेंगे कि मतलब ये एग्जैक्टली किस तरह की प्रोसीजर्स होती है यूनाइटेड नेशंस को भारत की समस्याओं को वहाँ पे रखने के लिए।
उसमें प्रॉब्लम ऐसा होता है कि ये जो कन्वेंशन है उसमें 4 मेजर कन्वेंशन है, लेकिन 6 मेजर कन्वेंशन है उसमें, और 3-4 भी बाद में आएंगे, लेकिन वो उतने वैल्यूएबल नहीं है। उसमें कमिटी ऑन चाइल्ड राइट्स, कन्वेंशन ऑन द राइट्स ऑफ द चाइल्ड, कन्वेंशन ऑन द राइट्स ऑफ द अगेंस्ट द डिस्क्रिमिनेशन ऑफ वुमेन, कन्वेंशन ऑन इकोनॉमिक सोशल कल्चर राइट्स, कन्वेंशन ऑन अगेंस्ट टॉर्चर, ये 4। उसके बाद में कन्वेंशन ऑन द सिविल एंड पॉलिटिकल राइट्स, दीज आर अबाउट 6, इज नॉट एवरी ईयर। एवरी कंट्री हु हैज बिकम ए मेंबर ऑफ द यूनाइटेड नेशंस, they have to sign an agreement that they agree with those conventions. They might put some reservations on one or the other clause. So this continued in the United Nations as a proof, and then every 4 years they are supposed to submit a report. India did not submit a report for 14 years on that. India just neglects all these matters, and they, many times they get away with the situations.
So first step is we have to represent these problems in the convention.
जो जो committee जो है, treaty bodies बोलते हैं उनको, तो ये 4 या 5 या 6 treaty body में these matters have to be reported.
And anybody can approach to them or how is the?
No, not anybody can approach. There is a procedure involved that the for going into the United Nations you have to have the accreditation and they know my work, so they had invited me. Otherwise, normally a consultative status committee, which has the recognition of United Nations, they only are allowed to participate.
So how that can be formed?
You have to write to the United Nations, the NGO committee, that you want to become a member. And India has been objecting to all 5 for the last 20 years. Because they don't want the caste system to be discussed at the world level. So they are practically banned, more or less. Every effort that is being done, even with the help of some European government, International Dalit Solidarity Forum, which is sitting in Denmark, Copenhagen, they also banned them also. And they have been struggling to get the equation. But I know the backdoor road, so I succeed in that matter. That's a different part. So, usko kiye bina, aapko raste nahi nikle. And India is very alert on this matter that no the institution which represents the caste system issue should be allowed. So they will raise any objection, and there is a continuous link of how you can delay this situation. I must have attended United Nations nearly about 30-40 every 6 months, 30-40 interviews, and then I found that it is not that easy. But somehow I found a backdoor road that I could get it inside. That's a different part. Over the years I got to know so many.
आज के तारीख में अगर किसी को अपने problems को represent करने हैं, so what can be the steps of क्या करना चाहिए उस केस में, मतलब कोई एनजीओ फॉर्म करके?
नहीं, एनजीओ का ही काम होता है वो, इसमें ये भी, लेकिन आप उनको लिख सकते हैं न्यूयॉर्क में, वो जो एनजीओ कंसल्टेटिव कमिटी है वहाँ पे, तो उनको लिख सकते हैं कि वी वांट टू बिकम अ मेंबर, तो उसके वेबसाइट पे गए।
एनी मेंबर कैन, एनी पर्सन कैन बिकम अ मेंबर और ऑर्गेनाइजेशन?
ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और एनी पर्सन इज नॉट अलाउड। एंड अमेरिका द यूनाइटेड ये कमिटी जो है इसकी, United Nations is a committee of the governments, for the government and by the government. So individual NGOs do not have any place. But when substitute question, when there is a hearing on that particular issue, then they allow the NGOs if they have consultative status. Otherwise, no. Yeah. And that is a very difficult part. Because if you are going to go after the qualified, and then every time you go, they will create out of your statements one issue and raise the objection in the end. Now since the time is up, you go for the next time. Next time again they play the same tactics. This is how it has been happening. Even with the help of the Denmark government, they tried also. Still they are not cured yet. So it's a very complicated process. I find the backdoor roads to get inside and get the job done. And I have not missed a single year. The United Nations, the different committees that have been working on it. And then, uske alawa,
second step, once we approach these NGOs,
you have to wait for their reply.
Okay.
They will invite you for the meeting in New York, And when you go to the New York, then there the Indian government will gradually stand up at the last minute. जैसा अभी 8 दिन का एक सेशन होता है उनका, मैक्सिमम 15 दिन, लेकिन 8 दिन यूजुअली होता है. 8 दिन के इसमें लास्ट डे पे वो सवाल निकालेंगे कि भाई ये इसका ये तुम्हारे पास में जवाब नहीं है बराबर, तो यू गिव द जवाब, उसके जवाब समय निकल गया. नाउ यू हैव टू गो टू नेक्स्ट टाइम, दे विल प्ले द सेम टैक्टिक्स अराउंड नेक्स्ट टाइम, फाइंड सम क्वेश्चंस, एंड ऐसा वो चलते रहता है. मेरा करीब करीब 30-40 बार हुआ है ऐसा अम्बेडकर सेंटर फॉर जस्टिस एंड पीस का, एंड द प्रोसेस इज कंटिन्यूइंग. सो आई नेवर वरी अबाउट इट एनीमोर. नाउ आई स्टॉप गोइंग टू द यूनाइटेड नेशंस ऑन गेटिंग द परमिशन. सो देयर आर few ways that how that could be done, that perhaps I will talk to you later. So I'm not going to talk to you now. And उसके बाद में 96 में कमिटी या सर्ट कमिटी ने इंडिया को चैलेंज किया. सो पहले इंडिया बोलने लगे कि नहीं ये तो सेम रेशियल डिस्क्रिप्शन का प्रॉब्लम है. बोले रेशियल डिस्क्रिप्शन नहीं, एनी डिस्क्रिप्शन बेस्ड ऑन द रिलीजन, caste, it's in the definition of Article 1 in that convention at all. And then the people go according to it. So then the Michael Banton was the chairman. He says, no, any discrimination based on sex, religion, caste and all these things has become an important part of the discrimination, any discrimination. So accordingly, that has to be addressed there. So they were completely for addressing this issue. And Indian government was in a shock that time, because this was the first time they were challenged by the United Nations Committee how this could happen. That article has been written by New York Times. It's given in the Google. Or if you put my name, you will find the articles, many articles that have come over the years. And there, उसमें जो उन्होंने लिखा हुआ है बड़ा clear लिखा हुआ है कि ऐसे situation में the committee finally decided, the CERT committee, which was the main body, उसका उन्होंने इंडिया ने 14-16 साल रिमाइंडर देने के बाद भी उन्होंने सबमिट नहीं किया था, वो उन्होंने बाद में सबमिट किया. एंड देन दे फाउंड दैट इंडिया जो बताता है इट्स वन थिंग एंड द रियलिटीज आर डिफरेंट. सो देन दे स्टार्टेड टू क्वेश्चन द क्रेडिबिलिटी ऑफ इंडियन रिपोर्ट. तुम अगर इतना बोलते हो कि तुम्हारी इतनी डेमोक्रेसी है, सब कुछ है, तो वॉट इज दिस हैपनिंग, हु इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दैट. ये जब हुआ तो इंडियन गवर्नमेंट वॉज कम्प्लीटली स्टॉप, कम्प्लीटली दे वर इन अ शॉक. हाउ डिड दिस पीपल, हाउ डिड दिस स्लेव्स कम हियर अप टू नाउ. एंड आई हैड डिसाइडेड दैट अनलेस आई पुश दिस इश्यू इन द इंटरनेशनल लेवल, नथिंग कुड बी डन. तब उसमें 97 में कमिटी ऑन इकोनॉमिक सोशल कल्चरल राइट्स आई, आई रिप्रेजेंटेड देयर ऑल्सो. जस्टिस भगवती was a member of that. Justice Bhagwati is the retired Chief Justice of the Supreme Court at that time. And there also one question came by asked by Ashok Desai, was the Attorney General of India that time. And one of the members, distinguished member, professor of the law, international law, she asked Mr. Desai, because we told her that the Devdas system, otherwise they get polluted by the touch of a human being. But they can rape our girls, kill our girls, that is very common. So then she questioned that to Desai. He said, what is this practice? Why this is happening? It seems to be all is a part of the caste system. So why don't you get rid of the caste system? So Mr. Desai was on the spot, shocked, what to answer now? I said, no. The caste system, we want to know about it. We are definitely prohibited by the constitution. But to have an affirmative action program, we have to know their caste, and that is why it is continued. As I said, you know, बात छटक दी थी गुजरात का गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया में. सो 97 में ये होगा, उसमें उन्होंने बहुत से जजमेंट सपोर्टिंग द प्रीवियस कॉर्पोरेटिंग ऑब्जर्वेशन ऑफ सर्ट कमिटी 1996, वो उसमें ऐड हो गए. देन 1990 ईयर 2000 में देयर वाज अ कमिटी ऑन चाइल्ड राइट्स. सो इन द कमिटी ऑन चाइल्ड राइट्स मैडम कार्क फ्रॉम द इजराइल, शी वॉज अ स्पेशल रिपोर्टर. एंड दैट मैडम कार्क सेड दैट आई हैड बीन जस्ट नाउ रिसेंटली टू इंडिया, आई वॉज इन राजस्थान, And Indian government is very smart in lobbying group. Whenever there is a foreign conference, they will just create a committee and see that they are abiding by all the rules, make a show of that, and try to bypass the system. They have done that many times, and I know the lobbying efforts of Indian government very well over the years.
They don't want to expose.
Yes. So they don't want to expose. They want to cover up the caste system at any cost underneath. Because even in the machinery, all the highest officer in India are Brahmins.
Yeah.
All the top to bottom people are all Brahmins. And they do not want, they want to defeat the system what the United Nations has created. Okay. This is what is happening. So, finally, I gave a lot of proof. There was Supreme Court judgment was there according to Constitution, I think Article 44, that asked compulsory free education to all the kids in the world, in India, at no cost, and that should be up to the age of 14. So then she gave very strong recommendations on that, education, and the destruction of the religious systems and all those things. And after that, in 2008, Committee on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights came into effect. There also we represented the issue of violation of our economic, social and cultural rights. And all those things, not a single newspaper of India, which is controlled by the Brahmins, has published, because we sent it to most of the newspapers, etc. So we didn't worry about it, we just kept on going ahead. Then in 2005, the Committee on 2005, the World Summit on Social Development and the World Summit on Information Technology took place. There we brought this issue. Then the right of every child to have the access to the information technology, that we demanded. That resolution was passed by all the different NGOs of the different countries in Europe, etc. That was a positive development. And then after 2005, there was a repetition of what the people have done in the Durban conference, so we attended some of this. So the last 30 years I have been continuously going to one or the other conference. Recently that thing happened that 40,000 of the Alshudra, the Namshudras from Bengal, were slaughtered by the army, by the police department of the Bengal, and the news was kept so great. They probably the Bengalis, central government with the Congress had a collaboration for majority with the cabinets. So the result was they did not allow even the parliamentary delegation to come and inquire. And all it happened was Nehru promised them that this district where Namshudra population is very high, they should allow them to come back if they don't like it. They refused to go to Bangladesh, and four districts were given to the Bangladesh during that, added to their requirements. And during that time, when they did not like it, they started to come back. So the Brahmin chief minister, I think it was most probably Buddhadev, there, he asked them to go to the Dandakaranya area, Marijapachi area, in Marijapachi jungle. And there, when they went there, these people have stopped their food. That was on 26th of January 1979. So when they started to revolt against it, they sent 25 police sailboats, and they killed every one of them. 40,000 people, including children, women and men, were killed at point blank, and not a single discussion was allowed. So it is a very shocking news. These were all Namshudra, the scheduled caste people who came from that. So these things are happening non-stop. And we have been awakening the civil society in these different directions. So it's a